Greetings everyone. In today's video, I'm going to demonstrate how I use layer control in my drafting work when I'm working with a CAD program. This is going to be about layer control and how it's used. Now, if you're using a different program and you're curious about BricsCAD, this may be a good opportunity for you to see some of the stuff that BricsCAD can do. It's going to be similar to other programs that are out there. You'll notice that a lot of the things are the same. So I think maybe for anybody that's just curious, this would be a good one to follow as well. In addition, if you're somebody that has never worked with a CAD program, this could be an opportunity for you to just learn something about how a CAD system works. So who am I? Well, I'm RB, and I have 30 years of CAD experience. And I started using the BricsCAD program in 2017. And I've been really happy with it. It's been my main go-to for all my plans. Occasionally I'll jump off and use another program if it's required for a project. Okay, what are some of the methods that CAD operators use to control layers? Well, first of all, creating layers. Layers are created with meaningful names, colors, line types, line weights, transparency, and plot settings. Assigning objects to layers. Objects are drawn on the current layer by default. Design object layers to specific layers. Operators can use the layer control command. Changing the current layer. The current layer can be changed by clicking on its name in the properties manager or in the layer control menu. Controlling layer visibility. The visibility layers can be controlled using the on and off or freeze thaw options. This helps reduce visual complexity of the drawing and improve display performance. Locking and unlocking layers. Layers can be locked to prevent accidental modifications. Using layer filters. Layer filters can be used to manage the display of the layers in the layer properties manager. Overriding layer properties. The properties of individual objects can be overridden, allowing them to display differently from the default properties of their layers. Non-plottable layers. The non-plottable option can be used to prevent a layer from being included in the print output. And so those are just some of the methods that CAD operators will use to control layers. There's probably some other things that you could do with it. Layers are a very important component in a CAD drawing. One of the basic fundamental elements that somebody should try to master and utilize to the fullest extent is the layer control. So here we are in our CAD program. This is BricsCAD. We're going to work with layers. So this is the layers one. This would be if you were looking at properties, you want to find out properties. Here's the layers menu. This will give you all the different elements on each of the layers.
Objects.
So again, layer control is important. So and it doesn't drill down what they are, but it'll tell you, okay, so the lower four level has two blocks that are assigned to this layer. So it kind of gives you an idea of what's in it. Text layer, let's see, mostly just text. And then here, I just got a few things. And so that's the basic toolbar. And here we're back into layers. And then from the layers menu, start at the top. Here we can control if we want to see XRef layers. So I mentioned that I use XRefs. We could turn those, we could toggle that on or off from here. And can hide them. So you see that this one here is labeled base site. So they'll have all the layers in the base site. And if you don't need to look at those, you can hide them from here. Hide. You can apply filters to the layer toolbar. You can indicate which filters are in, layers are in use. So over here on this side, it gives you the layers that are being used and the layers that are not being used. So that's pretty handy. One more thing that you can do is you can change the way that it looks. So if you wanted a compact view, which is kind of nice for when you're using a lot of layers, you can get to them quickly that way. And what I'll normally do is I put them in order here with a name. I just like to name them a certain way so that they're in order. And then we could do a more comfortable view. This is larger lines. So maybe if you're working with layers and you're getting tired of looking at the compact view, you can do it over there. Change that. So there's some options that are in there in the settings. And then next we've got a drop down menu that comes out. You can invert your layers and then you can also change the layer status. So this is a status control here. I could turn all the layers on from this one, so you can see that. And now I have an image in there, so I turn on all the layers that are possible. I could go to basic elements. This is just showing the layers within the drawing that are necessary. So in my drawing here, and you can see I have other blocks set up there. Or I could use what I call a working status. So this would be like my normal working thing, and it'll just automatically control which layers are on or not. And so if you start making changes to the layers, you can change the colors and do different things. Come back here and say, okay, working layer, I can just make the, bring it back to the, restore it to that position so that we're back the way we were working with from the beginning. We made changes, but we were able to come back to it pretty quickly that way. So the status is pretty nice. And then as far as layer control goes, you can do individual layer control here. So say, like I've got coordinates on, so say I want to shut those down. I don't want to see them anymore. So basically what a coordination layer is just kind of gives me lines, or I can do boxes around that I want to see how big they are.
Object. So
I often see them as yellow, because that's the color I use for that. So wherever you see a yellow line, it could be a coordination color. So like for the doors. And then if I want to turn off, say, I got existing or new, let's turn off new electrical. So I'm going to come over here. I'm going to find electrical, foundation, new electrical, and I'm going to shut that off. So that clears out my drawing so I can see a little bit clearer what's going on. Okay. Or if I want to, this is right now just a base drawing, so this would be just for working with this. But if you add it in a viewport in a paper space, you can toggle that on and off from paper space and use the same layer control system for that one. That if you have set up that way. And then, so as far as this goes, you know, you can add layers here. You can delete layers, purge layers. We've got Layer Explorer that we can launch from here. Layer states, so you can see those. You can hide the XREF symbols. On and off, hide XREF. So that's basically just doing taking XREF on and off, just the same as what happens up here. Hide XREF. Or you can do it from there. So there's other ways to get into it. And here you can open the dialog box here for layer states right away. It launches that. So this is a separate window that pops up. And then if you want to use the Layer Explorer and just look at layers in a big line, big window, you can do it from Layer Explorer. And that's basically the same stuff. In Layer Explorer, you can visualize the whole line all the way across. Transparency, so sometimes we'll have set transparency for, usually for existing stuff, I'll set the transparency at 50% so that when we're viewing an existing condition, it'll be faded out a little bit. So that's a fade transparency. I don't really worry too much about plot styles because I don't use that. I can set layers that are plot determined, if they're going to plot or not. So we have several layers that we use that are just there as big background. They don't get plotted. Usually those will be no plot, or something I have that I don't need to plot, I'll put on there. No plots. Okay, so that's basically that. I don't think I want to have roof edges in the plot. I want to make sure that gets on a plot. These other things, yes, plots. Okay, so let me pick something while we're at it. All right, so that's layer control. Pretty simple. That's pretty much it for today's episode, and I really appreciate that you spent time watching the video. If you can, please hit the like button. And if you didn't like today's video, of course, please subscribe, and maybe you'll like the next video. I need more subscribers as well as likes and views. So anything that you can do to help me there will be really appreciated. This is the end. So this is RB signing off.